All right, here's another example of using the chain rule to take a derivative. So let's see, what can we do? Well, we can write out the y's and u's and dy du, du dx and all that stuff, or we can use the function notation and f of g of x and things like that. What I'd rather do is I'd rather just use words and sentences to kind of guide our way through this. So to use the chain rule, you want to take the derivative of the outside. So that's the first thing, derivative of the outside. So what's the outside function? Well, it's the sine here, the sine of all this stuff. So the derivative of the outside is just cos. The derivative of sine is cos. So derivative of the outside, repeat the inside. So cos x squared plus 1, we repeated the inside. Okay, great. Times by the derivative of the inside. So that's the derivative of the inside is just 2x. And that's our derivative. So when you break things down into a sentence, it becomes easier. So let me say the whole sentence all at once. The derivative of the outside, repeat the inside, times by the derivative of the inside. Let me say that one more time. The derivative of the outside, repeat the inside, times by the derivative of the inside. Okay, let's look at another example. How about, let's take the derivative of the square root of 3x minus 4x cubed. Okay, well, let's use the sentence to try and help us. So, what's the inside? What's the outside? With a square root, it's pretty easy. The inside is inside the square root, and the square root is on the outside. But first, before we do this, let me just convert this, and you should do the same when you encounter a problem like this. Let's convert this to a power. The square root is really a power of 1/2. Okay, so now we can start by using our sentence. Derivative of the outside. Well, that's the power of 1/2, so that comes down. And we have to subtract 1 from the power, so that will be 1/2 minus 1, which is negative 1/2. So that's the derivative of the outside. Repeat the inside. 3x minus 4x cubed times by the derivative of the inside. So that's just going to be 3 minus 12x squared. And that's all there is to it. We've just successfully taken this derivative. So the chain rule, once you get used to it, and once you really understand that sentence, take the derivative of the outside, repeat the inside, times by the derivative of the inside. If you can get that and absorb it, then the chain rule will become a breeze from now on. But in a future video, we will look at chain rules where we have to go multiple layers deep. So there will be more than one inside. But we'll see that in the next video. See you then.